Hello everyone. Again we came out with a new chapter of India Yearbook by the name of Environment. The Environment chapter ki apni hi ek visheshta hai. The Environment chapter is having their own significance. 2005 to 2019, every year, Environment minimum is providing 7 to 8 questions. Maximum the range is going till 27 questions. Last year PT 2019 Environment chapter gave, or the Environment as a subject provided around 19 to 20 questions, and all the questions were contemporary, theoretical and legislative in nature. Kehne ka matlab hai, whatever question came, they were only from specific areas. So first of all, before starting the Environment, we should learn the significance of this chapter. Environment is that type of thing which is relevant throughout the world. After Corona, it will become more relevant. Whatever text or the material available in the market, majority of you are referring one or two material, they are just providing the orthodox things, basic concepts about environment, some of the organizations and their major part. That thing can give only 3 to 4 to 5 questions. But majority of the things which are contemporary in nature, wo koi nahi kara paata. That's why in Aspire, before doing this chapter, I want to tell you one thing. We are always ready to help the genuine and the very, very hardworking students throughout the country who are struggling because of the quantity, not the quality. So quality dene ke liye, we came out with Good Morning Times. Aap sab log monthly booklets padhte ho, that is good, no problem at all. But we are coming with monthly topic-wise documents. So if you are going to Aspire IAS, we crafted one of the very good segment, Student Zone. नाम से समझ में आ रहा होगा, ये जोन जो आपके लिए फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट, क्योंकि इसमें हम चाहते हैं हर बच्चे को हर चीज मिले और वो अपनी बेसिक तैयारी कर सके थ्रू एस्पायर और उसको कोई भी डिफिकल्टी ना आए. तो यू कैन डू योर दैट द प्रिपरेशन द स्मूथ मैनर. तो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टूवर्ड्स द स्टूडेंट जोन, दे आर द टू सेक्शन, वन इज फ्री मटेरियल एंड वन इज एस्पायर स्टूडेंट्स. द एस्पायर स्टूडेंट मीन्स दोज हु आर फ्रॉम क्लास और ऑनलाइन, देयर इज अ कोर्सेज, दे कैन गेट द क्लास मटेरियल देयर. But in the free, if you're going to the environment section, you will get month-wise Good Morning Times from 2017. So environment section is that much important. In today's class, India Book chapter is providing one chapter by the name of Environment. We prepared one of the very, very good material. Because as a student, when I'm thinking, I am feeling that I'm not having any crux material which I can revise in a very, very small, that is a period of time. So we came out with review and revise environment in 45 minutes and we crafted that booklet. That booklet I can also tell in this, there's a video I can teach in this video, is available under PT Kunji, under this video section, even under the UPSC monthly magazine. So when you are going to UPSC monthly magazine, you will get November, December 2019 monthly magazine plus environment in 45 days. So this is my humble request that please review this booklet. Because this booklet contains the list of all the national parks, all the tiger reserves, all the wetlands, all the biosphere reserves which are recognized by UNESCO, plastic management, solid waste management, e-waste management, biomedical waste management, National Board for Wildlife, working of Minister of Environment, the guidelines regarding the National Biodiversity Authority. So whatever is an important thing, which according to me is very vital for environment revision. We are not saying that it will complete 100%, but it can complete all the vital sections which are the necessity for the UPSC examination, plus Good Morning Times. So we are wasting our time in a traditional, that is a booklets, in which we are learning everything, oligotropic, eutropic lake, sab padhte chale jaate hum log. To padhna to chahiye pura environment ek baar, lekin we can set our priority ki question kahan se aa rahe hain. So this is my humble request that 2.5 years of environment news should be there in your mind. That's why 2017, 18, 19 and 20 Good Morning Times are there in the student zone. So aap usko jarur recommend kare. So today again this lecture is under 3 compartment. First we can do the summary of environment from my side. Then we can read our handout environment in 45 days. And then we can do the chapter of environment in India yearbook. So environment, what is environment? Now this lecture, earlier people liked it because I can tell you the summary of whole climate change. So listen carefully now. Switch off all the mobiles, make it in the aeroplane mode or download by video, listen carefully. And this 45 minutes at least can give you one question in PT and 2 or 3 questions in mains and interview. बिलीव मी, तो थोड़ा कंसंट्रेट हार्ड रखिएगा। तो एनवायरनमेंट क्या होता है, पहला ये क्वेश्चन है, व्हाट इज एनवायरनमेंट? एनवायरनमेंट मींस आवर इमीडिएट सराउंडिंग कंप्राइजिंग ऑफ बोथ बायोटिक एंड एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट इज नोन एज एनवायरनमेंट। अब आप कुछ चीजें सोचिए, इंसान कितने अच्छे और कितने बुरे भी हैं, फ्रॉम 22nd वी आर नॉट गोइंग आउटसाइड, व्हीकल्स इंटेंसिटी आर डिक्रीजिंग 1/10, राइट नाउ व्हीकल्स आर रोमिंग ओवर द रोड्स, एज पर एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स द पॉल्यूशन लेवल हैज बीन डिक्लाइनिंग वेरी फास्ट, इफ यू सी यू कैन मेजर द स्टार्स इन द स्काई अगेन, एंड जालंधर पीपल अकॉर्डिंग टू हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स बिफोर 2 days विजुलाइज द धौलाधार रेंजेस फ्रॉम जालंधर। दैट मीन्स बिफोर दैट पॉल्यूशन वॉज दैट मच इंटेंस दैट पीपल वॉज नॉट इन द कंडीशन टू विजुलाइज द धौलाधार हिमालयन रेंजेस, बट एनवायरमेंट इज दैट टाइप ऑफ थिंग इन विच वी आर लिविंग, बट दिस ह्यूमन्स दैट मीन्स वी ह्यूमन्स आर कंटेमिनेटिंग इट थ्रू टॉक्सिक गैसेज, थ्रू टॉक्सिक केमिकल्स इन द वाटर एंड द सॉयल, थ्रू ओवर एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर, ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर मेकिंग दिस एनवायरमेंट सम हाउ डिग्रेडिंग, विच इम्पैक्ट अवर ह्यूमन बॉडी इट्सेल्फ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेज, हार्ट डिजीजेज। एज पर लेंसेंट रिपोर्ट पॉल्यूशन इज अ मेजर रीजन बिहाइंड COPD, लंग डिजीज, दैट इज क्रॉनिक, दैट इज COPD, क्रॉनिक ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव पल्मोनरी डिजीज, कैंसर, हार्ट डिजीज, रेस्पिरेटरी डिजीज, ब्रोंकाइटिस, ऑल दीज आर द प्रॉब्लम। तो कोरोना वायरस इज प्रोवाइडिंग वन लेसन दैट दिस अर्थ बिलोंग टू अस, इट इज नॉट द कोरोना वायरस बट नेक्स्ट टर्न बिलोंग टू ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, इफ यू आर नॉट कंट्रोलिंग इट सम हाउ इट कैन डिस्ट्रॉय द ह्यूमन सोसाइटी एंड दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट क्यूरेबल। तो अभी जो हम एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स देखते हैं, दिल्ली, फरीदाबाद, गुड़गांव, गाजियाबाद 300, 180, 200, 250 भी चलते थे, नाउ इट इज 70, 90, 92, तो वी आर एंजॉयिंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ। तो एनवायरनमेंट शब्द का आविष्कार हुआ ड्यूरिंग 18th-19th century आफ्टर द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन। इन इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन ऑन द वन साइड पीपल जनरेट पर कैपिटा इनकम, ऑन द अदर साइड पीपल जनरेट गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ, बट वी आर नॉट नोइंग इट इज कमिंग ऑन द कॉस्ट ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट। बट दिस थिंग विजुलाइज बाय वन ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन बाय द नेम ऑफ क्लब ऑफ रोम, ये UPSC UPPCS राजस्थान में क्वेश्चन आ चुका है, क्लब ऑफ रोम। क्लब ऑफ रोम एक संस्थान बनी, वन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन क्लब ऑफ रोम, दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉज वर्किंग अपॉन दैट ह्यूमन कैन मेंटेन द बैलेंस बिटवीन डिग्रेडेशन और एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज एंड देयर कंजर्वेशन, इट शुड बी मेंटेन्ड। And they came out with a theory by the name of limits to growth. So limits to growth theory came, and this theory was just propounded by Club of Rome, and they are saying the speed of the exploitation of the resources by the few countries and the people, if not controlled, if not getting by the red capping after some years, humans will face the problem of water crisis, pollution, stagnation in the agriculture, degradation of the land and the soil, and it resulted into the mass migration of people from one continent to another, and it was one of the major reason behind the evolution of sustainable development theories. So Club of Rome came out with one of the theory by the name of limits to growth. Purpose was to generate the awareness and acknowledgement that the people should learn how to balance the balance between exploitation and conservation. But developed countries, emerging countries rejected this theory by saying it is anti-developmental. उन्होंने बोला ये सारी theories anti-developmental हैं. And when these theories are anti-developmental, then there is no means that we should accept. And it was the end of limits to growth. Then till 1950, the world countries, USA, Europe, were crafted a very, very high strategy. And they over-exploited the resources and resulting into good amount of release of gases. तो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दीज गैसेज हाउ दे आर इम्पैक्टिंग, ये थोड़ी देर में समझाता हूँ, पहले थोड़ी क्रोनोलॉजी पढ़ते हैं। तो टिल 1950 देर वॉज नथिंग कॉल्ड एनी टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, बट इन द USA, बट इन फ्रांस, यूरोप, द पीपल यूटिलाइज केमिकल्स, मेनली DDT, नाम सुना होगा आपने DDT, एंड इज DDT रिजल्टिंग इन टू द डेथ ऑफ फिशेज एंड सर्टेन टाइप ऑफ मॉडिफिकेशन इन द फूड साइकिल। देन फर्स्ट टाइम पीपल रिकोगनाइज दैट येस वी आर डिग्रेडिंग अवर एनवायरमेंट, but they didn't recognize anything about climate change. They are saying There is nothing called climate change, it is greenhouse gas. And earth is maintaining. So yahan main thoda greenhouse gas samjhata hu. Our earth is enveloped by greenhouse gases which are natural in nature, comprising of water vapor, methane, carbon dioxide, sulfur and nitrogen. These all are natural greenhouse gases, jisme particularly three main hain, water vapor, methane and carbon dioxide. सबसे ज्यादा वॉल्यूम में है कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, लेकिन सबसे ज्यादा इंटेंस ग्रीन हाउस गैस होती है वाटर वेपर एंड मीथेन. इंटेंस का मतलब है देयर अब्सॉर्बिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ हीट इज मोर देन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. इफ दिस एनवलप इज नॉट देयर देन द डे टाइम टेम्परेचर ऑफ द अर्थ वुड बी वेरी वेरी हाई एंड नाइट टाइम शुड बी वेरी वेरी लेस बिकॉज अर्थ इज रिलीजिंग द गुड अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी आफ्टर सनसेट एंड वी आर रिसीविंग गुड अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी ड्यूरिंग सनराइज. द एक्सट्रीम टेम्परेचर वुड बी देयर एंड देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ लाइफ ऑन द अर्थ. Therefore, this greenhouse gases has the property that when sun is there, they are allowing shortwave radiation to pass. Maybe this is your knowledge that all the hot substances or surfaces are releasing shortwave radiation. But this greenhouse gas is restricting the long wave radiation. By this, they are maintaining the optimum climatic condition over the earth. And that's why we are capable to reproduce, to do the agriculture and to cultivate the plants as well as crops. So developed country says there is nothing called climate change, it is called greenhouse gases only. Okay. Then in 1972, the first World Environment Summit took place by the name of Stockholm Conference. Stockholm Conference was the first World Environment Summit with the help of US President Nixon and India participated member Indira Gandhi. So India was always in support of environment and environmental conservation. The good thing is that world acknowledged environment pollution. The bad thing was that they didn't recognize climate change. So in 1972, they organized Man Environment Summit. And in this Man Environment Summit, their perspective was how to control the pollution. India was one of the members. India recognized the environment, animals and change. That's why after 1972, India enacted Wildlife Protection Act 1972 and Project Tiger 1973. Fourth five-year plan. So, ye aap yaad rakhiyega. Then till 1972 to 1980s, no problem regarding any type of thing. But suddenly, events took place regarding rampant rainfall, melting up of glaciers as well as ice, that's the shields. And people recognize that something is happening. We are not facing the normal weather and climatic conditions. That's why 1988, अब यहाँ से मैं आपको chronology पढ़ाना शुरू करूँगा. That's why 1988 the first organization came regarding climate change by the name of IPCC. याद करते चलेगा IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. तो बच्चे कंफ्यूज हो जाते हैं कि हु इज कैलकुलेटिंग द क्लाइमेट चेंज. WMO नो, UNFCCC नो, इट इज IPCC, इंटरगवर्नमेंटल पैनल ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. एंड इट केम बिफोर UNFCCC. इन 1988 IPCC वाज टास्क विद कैलकुलेटिंग द क्लाइमेट चेंज. इनका काम पॉलिसीज का नहीं है, इनका काम है कैलकुलेटिंग द रेट ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. तो UPSC ऑलरेडी PT में पूछ चुका है हु इज कैलकुलेटिंग, नॉट UNFCCC. मैं बार बार बोल रहा हूँ, इट इज नॉट UNFCCC, इट इज IPCC, इंटरगवर्नमेंटल पैनल ऑन क्लाइमेट चेंज. तो इंटर गवर्नमेंटल पैनल ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज कैलकुलेटिंग द क्लाइमेट चेंज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ 100 ईयर्स ऑफ एवरेज. तो सपोज इफ दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग 2020 डाटा, दे आर कंपेयरिंग विद 1920 डाटा. तो ऑन द एवरेज ऑफ 100 ईयर्स दे आर विजुलाइजिंग द रेट ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. देन IPCC गिव द 100% रिपोर्ट दैट यस क्लाइमेट चेंज इज हैपनिंग. अर्थ एवरेज टेम्परेचर हैज बीन इंक्रीजिंग, एवरेज टेम्परेचर हैज बीन इंक्रीजिंग. एंड देन it was the debate that we should do something. Just after 4 years, in 1992, the world organized the second summit by the name of Earth Summit or Rio Summit at Brazil. In 1992 Rio Summit, the four things took place. Number one, UNFCCC, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Second, CCD, that is Convention on Combating Desertification because of land degradation. Then CBD, Convention on Biological Diversity, and Agenda 21, that is Agenda for 21st Century regarding Sustainable Development. So in 1992, the four things came, and in these four things, the world country want to devise certain type of mechanism. So now we can discuss one by one all the basic things about 1992 Rio de Janeiro summit. They are saying it is a time that world countries should come together, and here they can provide two words. One is protocol. Protocol ka matlab hota hai legally binding treaties. If you are the member of this protocol, it is legally binding on you. If you are not guiding by the provisions of this treaty, international community can take the action against you. And second is convection. Convection. Convection ka matlab hota hai, it is just the convention. Under this, the two words are coming, ratify. Ek hota ratify, ek hota signing. Signing doesn't mean that you can imply this convention in your country. Signing means we are agree with this convention, provisions are good. But ratification means you can pass the legislation in your country. You can pass the legislation in your country. And when you pass the legislation in your country, now you can apply all the provisions of this treaty in your country. For example, India ratifies so many convention we signed, like corruption, human rights, but we never ratified. So ratified ka matlab hi hota hai ki usse related hum apne desh mein legislation ko pass karenge, that is known as ratification. Ab hum 1992 ko padhte hain. These are some terminology jo mujhe lagta hai which is important for you. Now sabse pehle CCD, Convention on Combating Desertification. There is a difference between desert and desertification. Yaad rakhega, desertification alag hota hai, desert alag hota hai. Desert means a naturally occurred thing available on the tropical latitude on the western side. All the deserts of the world are on the tropical side on the western part, or Arctic, Antarctica, cold deserts. These deserts are having less rainfall, 30 cm to 0 cm. And these deserts are the result of anti-cyclonic condition, ACC. ये डेजर्ट्स होते हैं, जितने भी डेजर्ट्स होंगे वहां पर क्या होगा, एंटी साइक्लोनिक कंडीशंस. हवाएं ऊपर की तरफ नहीं जाएंगी, नीचे की तरफ आएंगी. एंटी साइक्लोनिक कंडीशन बस पीटी के लिए याद रखेगा. बट डेजर्टिफिकेशन इज अ मैन मेड फिनोमिना अंडर विच वी आर डिग्रेडिंग अवर लैंड. डिग्रेडिंग अवर लैंड, तो डेजर्टिफिकेशन एक मैन मेड फिनोमिना है जिसमें हम अपना लैंड को डिग्रेड कर देते हैं. अंडर डेजर्टिफिकेशन थ्री कंडीशन आर देयर. नंबर वन, फॉल्टी एग्रीकल्चर प्रैक्टिसेस लाइक अवर ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन. So our whole green revolution area is under desertification. Number two, over pressure over the land. कि land पर हम ज्यादा लोगों को pressure डाल रहे हैं. Over grazing. क्योंकि जानवर जब over grazing करते हैं तो मिट्टी को lose कर देते हैं. तो desertification का मतलब हुआ loosening or drying of soil, which is top 3 to 5 cm, which is highly fertile and it is wash away. That means washing up of topmost soil, which is highly productive in nature, is known as desertification. And desertification is one of the major reason behind mass migration. According to United Nations, this problem is more severe than climate change. Particularly, याद रखना. So more severe than climate change, the problem of desertification is there. And this problem of desertification is very harsh. If we are not controlling it, it can destroy the world agriculture. People got mass migrated. The classical example is Sahel region of Africa, which is the extension of Sahara Desert. So the whole North Africa is under the desertification. Second part is India. That's why recently India conducted in 2019 the desertification summit and providing the guideline of 2030. UPSC mein question aaya tha. So India recently organized the CCD convention and providing the deadline of 2030 by which we can reclaim all the land which is saline, alkaline as well as degraded in nature. So under CCD we talks about land regeneration. इसी के लिए बोन चैलेंज, जो क्लाइमेट चेंज का पार्ट है, दोनों का पार्ट है, लैंड डिग्रेडेशन एज वेल एज क्लाइमेट चेंज. अंडर बोन चैलेंज वी कैन कल्टीवेट द फॉरेस्ट, वी कैन प्रमोट एग्रो फॉरेस्ट्री एंड फार्म फॉरेस्ट्री, ट्रेडिशनल एग्रीकल्चर सिस्टम लाइक क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन, मल्चिंग वेयर वी कैन प्रोवाइड लेटरिंग ऑफ द ऑल द लीव्स एंड ब्रांचेस एंड बायोमास ओवर द सॉइल, एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो प्रमोट दैट इज टेरेस फार्मिंग एंड काउंटर बंडिंग to control the soil erosion and desertifications. Above all, sustainable agriculture, zero waste natural farming, organic farming, all these are the solution under CCD, and India is a member of CCD over. Bas itna yaad rakhna hai. Chal acha lag raha ho, revise karte rahiyega, speed slow kar lijiyega agar tez ho, aur baar baar sun sakte hain YouTube pe, koi paisa nahi lagta, you can listen multiple times, but you can give the time, seriousness as well as consistency. If I am consistent in providing the video, you should also consistent in learning it. And if you liked, share with all the people who really want to complete their entire book within the time period. After CCD, it is CBD, Convention on Biological Diversity. Biodiversity means range of species, genes, and ecosystem. That's why biodiversity can be calculated in a three part: species biodiversity, genetic biodiversity, and ecosystem biodiversity. Biodiversity can provide our existence over the earth. For example, there is one series over the Netflix zoo. Usko aap dekhiyega, usme genetics dikhaya gaya hai, how it is important. I can give you live example. India is threatened about tiger population and lion. Why? The two females and five males are responsible for 200 population of lion. That means this 200 population is having same type of genetic makeup. If any disease attack with there, they will easily die within 1 hour. And we lost all the lion population in our country. That's why it is a recommendation that two African lions should be meeting with two Asian lions. Some tiger of Russia should meet with some Nepal, some India, and some Bangladesh. By this thing, we can enhance the biodiversity, and biodiversity give us the adaptation in the condition of climate change, environmental changes, or any natural changes. That's why biodiversity is always important. See our condition of agriculture. During the time of Indus Valley Civilization till Britishers, India had more than 1000 variety of rice which was cultivated throughout the country naturally through pollination. But after Green Revolution and now GM crops, they introduced monoculture, and monoculture converted this 1000 into 2 to 3 types of crops. That means we are reducing our biodiversity very high. So to control all these mechanisms, CBD world, people and countries recognize that climate change, humans, their practice of monoculture, their practice of captive breedings, even natural changes are responsible regarding the declining of biodiversity. Even we are killing the agents of biodiversity, that is birds. Birds, bats, butterfly, even all the small bugs like black bugs, yellow bugs, in sab ko hum maar rahe. UPSC asked this question 2 times. Who are responsible regarding pollination? Answer is very simple. Pollination belong to those animals who are having hairs over the, that is our legs, and they are nectar sucking animals, all are the pollinating agent. But we are destroying it because of the destruction of habitat, which resulted into the overall destruction of biodiversity. CBD in sabko preserve karta hai. So CBD ke andar pehli baat aayi, that every country passed the national legislation. That's why in India 2002, we came out with National Biodiversity Authority or law, under which Chennai, we are making the Biodiversity Authority, and we make the decentralized mechanism national, state, district, and panchayat for the conservation and reporting of biodiversity. We are making it responsibility of every organization, state department to conserve the biodiversity, especially the local people and the tribal people. It is in a handout. And second thing, they are talking about biopollution. That's why for the world, they came out with Cartagena Protocol. Cartagena Protocol major purpose is only one, that this Cartagena Protocol talks about safe handling, transfer and use of GMO and LMO, genetic modified organism and living modified organisms. Cartagena Protocol ko अप्लाई करने के लिए भारत में आए जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्रूवल कमेटी, जो बाद में बन गई जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्राइजल कमेटी. तो इन इंडिया टू कंट्रोल द बायो पोल्यूशन वी आल्सो हैव अवर ओन एजेंसी बाय द नेम ऑफ जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग अप्राइजल कमेटी. देन यूएनएफसीसीसी, यूएनएफसीसीसी ऑर्गेनाइज द ग्रुप ऑफ कंट्रीज हु आर कमिंग टूगेदर एंड डिस्कस अबाउट क्लाइमेट चेंज. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज अ मल्टीलेटरल इंस्टीट्यूशन. मल्टीलेटरल मीन्स बहुत सारे इंस्टीट्यूशन एक साथ आते हैं और एक साथ डिस्कस करते हैं अबाउट द थिंग. बट फ्रॉम 1992 टिल 1997 देयर वाज नो दैट मच प्रोग्रेस. देन पीपल एक्नॉलेज दैट क्लाइमेट चेंज इज अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम एंड वी नीड सर्टेन टाइप ऑफ लॉज टू कंट्रोल दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. That's why in 1997 people came out with Kyoto Protocol, who divided the country under Annex 1, Annex 2, non-annex countries and least developed countries. This Kyoto Protocol talks about clean development mechanisms, joint implementation, carbon credits or certificates. These are the three important things. But from here, one important concept take place: common but differential responsibility, CBDR, common but differential responsibility. Sab samjhata hu. Kyoto Protocol ne bola legally binding agreement. USA never signed it and never ratified it. That's why it is one of the reason behind the failure of Kyoto Protocol. So Kyoto Protocol mein pehla hai clean development mechanism. That means developed and developing countries can work upon renewable energy. All the mechanism by which we can generate the clean environment. Joint implementation means both developed, developing, least developed countries can implement jointly. And carbon credit ka matlab tha, suppose India conserve more carbon, but USA cannot conserve. India ko karna tha 100 units, but India ne kar liya 1000 units. That means 900 extra. USA ko karna tha 900, lekin USA ne kar diya 1800. So USA can purchase this 19 credits from India. And by this we are paying, means USA is paying to India. So India can earn and we can maintain the global average of carbon emission at par with the requirement of controlling the climate change. शायद आप मेरी बात समझ रहे होंगे, दैट इज नोन एज कार्बन क्रेडिट और कार्बन सर्टिफिकेट्स. तो आगे मैं बताऊंगा बिना बोर्ड के. तो टिल 1997 द वर्ल्ड कंट्री वाज नॉट हैविंग एनी लीगली बाइंडिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट, बट आफ्टर दिस 1997 वी हैड अवर लीगली बाइंडिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट बाय द नेम ऑफ क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल विच स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1997 एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेड थ्रू मराकेश ट्रीटी. तो क्योटो इज अ सिटी इन जापान, वहां पर कन्वेक्शन साइन हुआ, अप्लाई हुआ मराकेश के थ्रू, मराकेश ट्रीटी. देन क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल सेट द टारगेट ऑफ 2005, 2007 फर्स्ट एंड देन 2012, दैट बाय 2012 वी कैन अचीव द टारगेट ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड वी कैन मेक आवर ग्लोब प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम एनी टाइप ऑफ सी लेवल राइज, मेल्टिंग ऑफ ग्लेशियर्स एक्सेट्रा. बट समहाउ इट वॉज नॉट वर्किंग. देन द वर्ल्ड थ्योरीज वॉज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट. वन पर्सन और वन ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल आर सेइंग इट इज अ नेचुरल इवेंट and humans are not having any control on these natural events. They gave the example that last ice age was the Pleistocene and after that we are in the age of intraglacial period. Earth ke upar oil milta hai, coal milta hai, all these are the evidences. In the past when humans were not there, earth faced so many times of climate change. Agar aapne ice age movie dekha ho, glaciers develop and melts 7 times. So they are saying this climate change is a natural event and we people do not have any type of relationship in this. And they gave 5 theories. One is continental drift, ki jab continent ek latitude se dusre latitude par jata hai automatically temperature kam hoga ya badhega, to continental drift. Second, sun hot spot cycle. We are still not knowing why it is happening, but every 330 years sun emits more insolation which further resulting into increasing temperature over the earth. Then the third factor is volcanic explosion, as like Mount Krakatoa, Indonesia. In the Mount Krakatoa, Indonesia, because of the volcanic explosion, good amount of carbon dioxide, water vapor emitted in the globe. But the same time, aerosol is also spreading. Through jet stream, they are circulating throughout the globe, resulting into mini ice age. Then the fourth evidence, they are saying geomagnetic radiation over the earth. Earth is protected from harmful rays. Agar aapne padha ho. So because of the core and rotation, Earth is having that geomagnetic fields which are protecting from sun harmful radiations. But some years, 30, 40, 50, nobody is knowing, these geomagnetic field radiations are changing, which resulting into weakening of this radiation. During that period of time, sun harmful radiation entered, resulting into increasing temperature. Apart from that, tiltation. Earth is having 23.5 degree tiltation. That means that tropics we are having vertical rays. If 1 degree change, 23 to 24, around 1000 km area is coming more vertical rays, resulting again temperature rise. So these are the 5 theories which the people who are saying climate change is a natural event propounded. But even then they accepted the pace of this climate change which is naturally occurring has been increased by human beings through the release of water vapor, carbon dioxide, etc. But other people are saying it is the age of Anthropocene. Under Anthropocene age, humans are dominating. Humans are burning more fossil fuels, unsustainable activities, wastage of food, more consumption of meat, milk, all are resulting into release of carbon as well as methane. Cattle are the main source of methane. That's why in the European countries, mainly in UK, Germany, a new type of revolution take place by the name of milk-free products, because they are feeling that milk is also coming under non-veg. Any animal product they are banning, because animals are also one of the major sources of climate change and the methane. So in the Europe, this type of events are also going on. Then the world country says that short-term talks cannot work. It is a time that we should move towards long-term talks. Then all the world countries meet in Bali. Yesterday in the DNA, 3rd of April, I uploaded one of the document where the COP26, the upcoming one, suspended by 2021. In that document, I provided the chronology. So, you don't have to do anything. Aspire website, go to DNA, go to 3rd April, open it. And you will get that wonderful news regarding the summary of all the summit which I am going to tell you. So, Bali, Indonesia summit, first time provided the baseline for the long-term talks. That short-term talks doesn't work in the form of Kyoto Protocol 1. After Bali, world countries met in Copenhagen, Denmark. Ye chronology yaad rakhiyega. Copenhagen mein developed and developing country bifurcate. And there was a formation of new group by the name of basic countries. Under basic country, naam se samjha raha, B for Brazil, S for South Africa, C for China, I for India. These countries says we are ready to control the greenhouse gas emission, but we demand only one thing, USA participation and continuation of common but differential responsibility. Aapki jyada hogi kyunki aap 80 saal se pollution kar rahe ho, humari kam hogi kyunki humne abhi development karna shuru kiya hai. Even these countries are saying if we really want to achieve sustainable development goals, we want some concessions regarding the carbon emissions. But it was failed because America was not accepting. Then the world countries met in Cancun, Mexico. In Cancun, UK was a negotiator and there was the formation of Green Climate Fund. Not Adaptation Fund, Green Climate Fund. And this Green Climate Fund purpose was $100 billion which developed countries can give to developing and least developed country for the adoption of renewable energy and climate change restriction energy. But the major summit was Durban, South Africa after Cancun. Under the Durban, South Africa, the world countries draw the timelines for the first time for the long-term talks. So Durban mein timeline banaya gaya. Kyoto Protocol has been extended from 2012 to 17 and then 17 to 2020. 2020 is the last year that is present by which 100% we can adopt Kyoto Protocol 2 document or long-term climate change commitments. In the Durban, we provided the target 2 degrees centigrade, that global temperature by the end of 21st century should not increase more than 2 degrees centigrade on global average. But some country demanded, a small island country demanded 1.5 degree, but it was not accepted. Even within the Durban Platform for Action, they talks about CTCN, Climate Technology Change Network, or Climate Technology Center Network, where this network can do research and development regarding the overall, that is the implementation and the production of new renewable energy. Durban ke baad hum log Doha mein mile. In Doha, we are just implementing the Durban Platform for Action. Then the world countries met at Lima, Warsaw. Warsaw was important because in the Warsaw we talks about REDD plus. REDD plus is for regeneration of forest, under which India is also providing Kempa fund and the target of 20 million hectares of forest. After this, Warsaw ke baad Paris gaye 2015 mein. Paris was the deadline for the draft paper coming from Durban. So in the Paris in 2015, world countries negotiating regarding the draft paper of Kyoto Protocol 2. Isi samay baat aayi nikal ke International Solar Alliance, jiska pehli baar headquarter Bharat mein bana, an international organization, Gurugram. Under the Paris, the world country says it is a time to end the dispute of common but differential responsibilities. And then everybody is guiding by intended nationally determined goals. World countries boli, hum sabko impact padta hai. Don't reduce the greenhouse gases for world, reduce for yourself. Because you can also lose good amount of GDP. Under this consideration, it is a need that we people can control the problem of climate change by ourselves. India adopted three targets. First is 40% of energy out of total energy should be from renewable energy, 40%. 33 to 35% reduction in the carbon emission by 2030. And 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon sink through afforestation, bone challenge, RED plus, all these things were coming under Paris. Then we met at bone challenge aaya. Then we met at Katowice, Poland, 2018. Here they talks about implementation and transparency in the Green Climate Fund and electronic vehicle. And India adopted the FAME policy, F-A-M-E. Faster means in the adaptation of electric vehicles, so National E-Mobility Mission. Part 1 talks about manufacturing of 3-wheelers, 2-wheelers, even 4-wheelers hybrid vehicles. 2019 mission or budget talks about FAME 2.0. Under this FAME 2.0, we talks about electrification of public vehicles, buses, trams, all this thing can move through us electricity, not petrol or diesel. After that, last summit 2019 was proposed to be held in Chile, but because of the agitation, it was postponed and provided to Spain, Madrid, but it was not successful. 2020 summit planned to be held in Glasgow, Scotland, in UK, but now postponed to 2021. India in 2008 came out with their own program by the name of National Action Plan for Climate Change. Under this, 8 mission was selected. Mission number 1, Sustainable Agriculture. Mission number 2, Sustainable Urbanization. Mission number 3, National Mission for Water. Hum individual deal karenge ise alag alag chapter mein. Mission number 4, that is on enhanced energy efficiency. Mission number 5, that is strategic knowledge about climate change. Himalayas and Himalayas ecosystem. Green Mission, National Mission for Green India. And Sustainable Agriculture. These are the 8 missions under National Mission for Climate Change, where National Solar Mission is upgraded into 100 gigawatts, 60 on-farm and 40, that is the off-farm. Isi ke alawa, we also providing hydropower electricity, the infrastructure status, enhanced energy efficiency through star rating appliances, BEE iske liye banaya gaya, Bureau of Energy Efficiencies, sustainable urbanization ke liye hum graha and LEED green rating buildings leke aaye. कि बिल्डिंग शुड बी ग्रीन एंड यूजिंग मैक्सिमम नेचुरल सनलाइट एंड वाटर. जैसे अब हम यूज कर रहे हैं, बेसमेंट में पढ़ाते हैं, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में पढ़ाते हैं, तो लाइट चलती है एक साथ 16-20, 10 एसी, नो एसी, खूब इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जलती है. इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थर्मल पावर प्लांट से आती है. क्लाइमेट चेंज, आज हम नेचुरल सन की लाइट यूज कर रहे हैं, ओपन छत पर लेक्चर रिकॉर्ड कर रहे हैं. वी आर ऑल्सो सेविंग द कोल एज वेल एज कंट्रोलिंग द क्लाइमेट चेंज, इज अ क्लासिकल एग्जाम्पल. इसलिए हमेशा क्लासरूम ओपन होने चाहिए थे, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम है इन द दिल्ली लाइक कंजेस्टेड एरिया वी आर लैकिंग एंड देयर इज अ हार्श स्केर्सिटी ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. रेंट्स आर वेरी हाई, एक्सप्लॉयटेशन आर वेरी हाई, विच रिजल्टिंग इन टू फर्दर हाई इन द फीसेस. कॉम्पिटिशन इज वेरी हाई एंड एवरीथिंग डेट टू रेट्स. नाउ सी द मैजिक, यू टू फ्री, आई एम विलिंग टू गिव माई लेक्चर्स. सन एनर्जी इज नॉट चार्जिंग बाय द सन देवता, सूर्य भगवान पैसा नहीं चार्ज करते. हवा चल रही है इतनी मस्त, पीछे दिखाओ पीपल का पेड़ कैसे हिल रहा है. ऑल दिस टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स आर रिजल्टिंग इन टू सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट. रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर यही बोल के गए थे, लर्निंग इन नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट थ्रू नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन, बिकॉज अवर एनवायरनमेंट इज अ नेचुरल लेबोरेटरी. यही गांधी जी के तिलस्मान में लिखा हुआ है, दैट यू शुड लर्न थ्रू टकली. टकली में चखा, चरखा से हम बहुत कुछ सीख सकते हैं. ज्योमेट्री, ज्योग्राफी, इकोनॉमी, एग्रीकल्चर. So I am always adopting their guidelines because they are were the great masters and the teachers. And I am always believing you should also learn and future mein aap log bhi teach karenge apne bachcho ko aur choti choti nayi generation ko. So you should also adopt this type of methods. So this is the overall journey of the climate change and associated conventions. Iske baad separate columns are there which can be completed through the handouts as well as India Yearbook. To chalte hain uski taraf aur aage padhte hain. The whole environment completed by me only in 18 to 19 classes in a holistic manner. So this is a booklet, easy to pick, a series which we crafted for you, environment for PT in 45 minutes. Share this document with maximum people, they will enjoy and they will also bless you when the question will come from this booklet. So get ready and we can review this booklet. Yaad aapko hi karna hai. I can tell you how to use this booklet in a good manner. So first we are providing Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change.
Under this, only objectives are important. One is conservation and survey of flora, fauna, forest, wildlife, preservation and control of pollution, afforestation and regeneration of degraded areas, protection of the environment and ensuring the welfare of animals. Then Wildlife Institute of India 1982 mein bana tha. It is for training program, academic courses and advisory in the wildlife research and management. The institute is actively engaged in research across the breadth of the country on biodiversity related issues. The institute idyllic campus that has been carefully developed to great state of the art which encourages scholarly work. Indian Forest Service ki training bhi is institute mein hoti hai. Then United Nations Environment Program. United Nations Environment Program is leading the Global Environment Authority set the Global Environment Agenda, promote coherent implementation of the environmental dimension of sustainable development. Aapko mila hoga. Headquarter is in Nairobi, Kenya. Inger Anderson is the Executive Director. 7 broad themes pe kaam karta hai. PT ke liye yaad rakh lena, important. Then UNCCD, United Nations Convention on Combat Desertification 1994. Already maine aapko padha diya hai. To isko aapko padhna hai. Under this, India mein New Delhi Declaration 2030. And all these points are highly important, jo aap yaad karenge. All my students in the regular batch, you can also do this document in a careful manner. So United Nations Convention on Combating Desertification is highly important. And this point you should remember. Promoting project to prevent land degradation of at local, national and the regional level. Promote project to prevent drought and erosion and to make barren land cultivable. Plan to prevent drought so that land degradation can be prevented. Creating green jobs by promoting technology investment in collaboration with all stakeholders. Need to work towards preventing land degradation, taking forward Paris Agreement. Implementing United Nations Ecosystem Restoration Program on behalf of all countries. To further, program initiated by Africa countries to prevent land degradation. Peace Forest Initiative PT examination. This 8th point is important for PT. Appeal to make local government more accountable to prevent land degradation and make right to land transparent. Then COP 14 member countries appreciated India's effort. 2030 is the target. Then Global Environment Facility. Upar likh lo bada bada. This is the only agency which are providing the funding or finance. So this is the organization which is providing the funding. Aap yaad rakhiyega. The Global Environment Facility after 1992, 128 countries are the part. World Bank is providing the funds in 1991. After this, World Bank is a trustee in the GF funds. Headquarter Washington DC, these are the PT points. And they are giving in the 6 area, biodiversity, climate change, international water, ozone depletion, land degradation and persistent organic pollutant. Iska code hai. Bolo, main hoon ek bhaiya. Mera naam hai Ram Kumar. Main ban gaya IFS. IFS बनते साथ जिस जगह पर मैं गया वो था बायोडायवर्सिटी रिच, लेकिन मैंने देखा कि यहाँ पर क्लाइमेट चेंज की वजह से लोग मर रहे हैं, बायोडायवर्सिटी एनिमल्स मर रहे हैं. मेरे ही नेशनल पार्क के बराबर से इंटरनेशनल वाटर पास होते थे जहाँ चाइना का शिप जाता था और इस चाइना के शिप में से ऑर्गेनिक पॉल्यूटेंट्स निकलते थे. तो मैं एक जगह पर अपॉइंट हुआ. आई अपॉइंटेड इन वन एरिया रिच इन बायोडायवर्सिटी बट डिग्रेडेड बिकॉज ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. नियर टू माई बायोडिग्रेडेबल एरिया Chinese ship are passing from international water, degrading my ecosystem through organic pollutants. Then they are supplying the seed, jiski wajah se land degradation hua, aur uski ship ki wajah se, usme se jo nikla usse ozone depletion hua. So this is a very simple code you should remember, and you will always make it correct. Then these are the programs where GEF is providing the funding. Main already course mein kara chuka hu. My aspiring students can do the revision through this. CBD, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNCCD, Stockholm Convention and Minamata Convention. India is both donor and recipient in the GEF. Then UNESCAP, United Nations Economic and Social Council for Asia Pacific, you will read yourself. Then the list of tiger reserve, Andhra Pradesh, Nagarjuna Sagar, Arunachal Pradesh, Namdhapa National Park. The whole list of alphabetical wise state is there. You can remember it easily. After this India Yearbook, next session I will take the test. I can give you the time. On that day I can take the test. Everybody can get ready. And this test should be live. You can just log on and you can also give the test. Then Biosphere Reserve. Biosphere Reserve is an international designation by United Nations Education UNESCO for the part of natural and cultural landscape. Then criteria of designation of Biosphere Reserve. A site must contain a minimum distribution, distributed core area of value, natural reserve. Core area must be a biogeographical unit and should be large enough to sustain a viable population representing all trophic level. Involvement of local communities and use of their traditional knowledge. And area potential for preservation of traditional tribal. Iska matlab, biosphere reserve mein, not only plant animals but also tribals, tribals people, their genetic makeup and culture ko bhi hum conserve karte hain. Teen tarah ke area hote hain, core area fully restricted, buffer zone mein minimum and limited tourism and traditional area koi bhi aa sakta hai, settlement, crop kuch bhi ho sakta hai. National park mein purely restricted hota hai, wildlife sanctuary mein allowed hota hai, wildlife sanctuary is also for specific tree or the plant. Then function of the biosphere reserve, ye aap khud padhenge. 18 biosphere reserve in India, very important. And after that, India's internationally recognized biosphere reserve, and the most recent one is Kanchanjunga 2018 edition. Total 11 biosphere reserve is there. State wise, yaad karenge to answer rahega. Agar hum Nandani state se start karte to Nanda Devi. Nanda Devi ki baad agar aap niche ki taraf aate hain, to then Achkamar, Amarkantak, east mein Sundarban, then Nokrek in Meghalaya, central part Panchmari, main bata chuka hu, Simlipal in Odisha, then south mein aate hain Agastamalai. Then Achakumar, sorry, that is Great Nicobar. Then Gulf of Mannar and Nilgiris. Pehla tha Nilgiri. This is very important for repeat examination. Then national parks. The first national park in India is a Halley National Park, known as Jim Corbett National Park, 1972. Then what is national park and the list of national park. Then wetlands in India. India is having good amount of wetlands. Wetlands are the transitional zone between terrestrial and aquatic ecosystem. In India, majority of the wetlands are on the coastal region, all the Gulf, Bays, Delta, Estuaries or are wetlands. Even the tri region of Uttar Pradesh is having the wetlands. Eastern coast and western coast both are having more wetlands, but eastern coasts are having more mangroves wetland than western coast. Ye PT ke liye aap zarur yaad rakhiyega, east and west mein. Then what India's wetland are generally different, shade into 8 categories. These are the 8 categories of wetland and Ramsar Convention, Iran, where they are providing the criteria. These are the criteria, group A, group B. Group A ke andar a wetland should be considered internationally important if it contains a representative rare or unique example or a natural or near natural wetland type. Group B, then criteria and other things. So group A yaad hona chahiye, baki aapki marzi hai. Then Ramsar site convention, ye sab yaad nahi ho sakte, to ek bar read out zarur kar lena. Then Forest Survey of India, objective 33%, yahi pe likh do bada bada. Objective is 33%. India Forest Report aaya 2017 mein aur 19 mein, both are important. It is biennial in nature. Pehle key findings in 17 ki baat karenge. Forest cover has been increasing 24.39%. First time we are including the land and decommissioning of bamboo. India ranked 10th in the world with 24.4% of land area under forest and tree cover, even though it accounts for 2.4% of world surface area and sustain 17% of human and 80% of livestock population. India was placed 8th in the list of top 10 nations reporting the greatest annual net gain in forest area. State-wise analysis, 7 state duty have more than 75% of forest cover, Mizoram, Lakshadweep, Andaman, Nicobar, lekin northeast mein niche hua hai. Top 5 state with the maximum increase in the forest is Andhra Pradesh, followed by Karnataka, do bol hai. With maximum forest cover, top 5 states in terms of area, Madhya Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh mein area bada hai. Then 5 states where forest have decreased, Mizoram, Nagaland, sare northeast mein niche hua hai except Sikkim. Then mangrove cover is also increasing. 12 mangrove states have shown an increase in mangrove cover, 12 PT. 7 out of 12 mangrove states, 7 mein bada hai. And maximum is in again Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh. Water bodies ko liya gaya hai. Water bodies is also playing a major role. Maharashtra and Gujarat maximum increase. Bamboo cover is also increasing in our country. Bamboo is re-regularized. Then 2019 report. Further increase in the forest cover. Agar aap dekh lo 2019 report mein, Madhya Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh showing the maximum increase area wise. Then increase in the forest cover. The cover forest include all patches of land with a tree canopy density. So isliye increase dikha raha because we are including over the roads also, the trees there as a part of forest. More than 10% and more than 1 hectare in area. The top 5 states to show an increase in the forest cover include Karnataka now, Andhra Pradesh. Pehle Andhra Pradesh tha, Karnataka ho gaya. Declining the forest in the northeastern region further. But still government says no problem because density of forest is very high. Forest cover in tribal district is also increasing. Total forest cover in tribal district, which is 37.54% geographical area, there has been a decrease. So forest cover in tribal area decreased at 741 square kilometer mein. with the recorded forest green wash is there because of infrastructure projects. Increase in the tree cover in our country in comparison to 2017. Then carbon stock, wetland and forest produce is there. Then quick revision, ye aap khud padhenge speed se, regarding the forest report. Then national biodiversity, that is the Act 2002, objective to conserve the biodiversity guided by CBD, sustainable use of component of biodiversity, fair and equitable sharing guided by Aichi declaration, regarding to Japan, Aichi declaration, who talks about equitable ABS, that is the ABS means access, benefit, sharing and equitable sharing of the biodiversity among the nation who are sharing. Then a national biodiversity authority has been established by the Biodiversity Act 2002 to regulate act implementing regular 2004 has been operationalized since coming into the force. Then provision of the act, prohibition on transfer of India genetic outside, prohibition of anyone claiming an IPR such as patent over biodiversity, regulation of control and use of biodiversity by Indian national, measure for sharing of benefit for use of biodiversity including IPR, measuring the to conserve sustainable use of biological resources including habitat and species protection, provision for local communities to have a say in the use of their resources, protection of indigenous or traditional laws such as registration of such knowledge PT examination, regulating the use of genetically modified organism PT examination. All these are the part of Biodiversity Act. National State Local Biodiversity Fund banega and setting up a biodiversity management at the local level PT examination. Then National Biodiversity Authority function de rakha hai, aap khud padhenge. Then Project Tiger, Project Elephant, bas main amistad likh lena. Project Tiger mein recently Project Tiger took place in our country. The population earlier was 2226, now it is 2697. The maximum increase is on the eastern side of the country. Madhya Pradesh become the tiger capital. These all are the point. Then Animal Welfare Board of India, it is a major board to provide environmental clearances to those projects which are in the national park and biodiversity area. Then biomedical waste rule khud padhenge, solid waste management rule khud padhenge, sare point de rakhe hain. E-waste management rule khud padhenge, page number 32. Amendment to the e-waste management rule, plastic management rule. Then National River Conservation Plan, it is part of Ganga. Teen iske major point hai, regulation of industry, 5 km area preserve in the floodland, aur sabse important part iska ye hai, sea waste treatment plant. Sismau drainage in Kanpur is Asia largest, which providing the drainage. Recently government came out with the ecological flow concept, page number 37 par, by which every river can maintain the minimum flow. Then CRZ regulation 1, 2, 3, 4 definition. Then National Afforestation Program, 20 million hectares under National Green India Mission, Bone Challenge and others. Then Green India Mission A to Z, Kempa Fund, everything is there. It's a 43 page document, all the major part is there. Project Tiger is not in this document. You can take this under the free material, under the student zone, under the newspaper worksheets. So I hope that you will feel very good. इंडियर बुक चैप्टर में ये सब दे रखा है. इंडियर बुक चैप्टर में दिखा देता हूँ जल्दी जल्दी क्या पढ़ना है. वेट फॉर वन मिनट टिल वी कैन ओपन द इंडियर बुक एनवायरनमेंट चैप्टर. Now in this book, environment chapter is very lengthy. First, all the organization which is important, हमने बता दिया इसलिए अलग से दिया. Then biological survey of India, geological survey of India दे रखा है. Headquarter Kolkata. Major work is survey regarding the biodiversity of both flora and fauna. Then forest survey of India आप handout से पढ़ेंगे जो पहले पढ़ाया. Biodiversity conservation में CBD दे रखा है. Lecture में पढ़ा चुका हूँ. Biosphere reserve दे दिया है, इसमें से नहीं पढ़ना है, काटते चलो. Then biosafety, Cartagena protocol बता चुका हूँ, LMO, GMO. Then forest production, wildlife conservation, ये आप देख सकते हो, wildlife conservation पढ़ सकते हो. Then wildlife crime control bureau, they are working in our country simultaneously with the sites to control the overall wildlife theft. Then central zoo authority, protected by wildlife protection act 1972, बाकी कुछ important नहीं है. Then project elephant मैंने आपको दे दिया, project tiger दे रखा है 1973. अंडर कुछ नहीं दे रखा है, मैंने आपको टाइगर रिजर्व की लिस्ट दे दी है। देन एनिमल वेलफेयर, एनिमल बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया फॉर द एनिमल वेलफेयर, मोबाइल क्लिनिक। देन कंट्रोल ऑफ पोल्यूशन, वी ऑलरेडी गेव दिस हैंड आउट इन अवर स्टूडेंट जोन, लेकिन आप यहाँ पढ़ सकते हो। एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स 7, दैट इज गैसेज आर देयर और पोल्यूटेंट गैसेज आर देयर, कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, सल्फ्यूरिक ऑक्साइड, नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड, अमोनिया, लेड, ऑल दीज आर द पार्ट ऑफ AQI। बाकी इसमें ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं दे रखा है। मेजर्स रिगार्डिंग द कॉम्बैटिंग एयर पोल्यूशन में एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स यहाँ दे रखा है, लेकिन अगर अंदर पढ़ेंगे कुछ नहीं मिलेगा। नॉइस पोल्यूशन नहीं पढ़ना, काट दीजिएगा। देन स्कीम फॉर कॉमन एफ्लुएंट ट्रीटमेंट आप पढ़ सकते हैं। हैजार्डियस, दैट इज द सब्सटेंस मैनेजमेंट, स्टॉकहोम कॉन्फ्रेंस आती है इसके लिए। देन हैजार्डियस वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट में ऑलरेडी आपको हैंड आउट में दे चुका हूँ, ये नहीं पढ़ना है। सॉफ्टवेयर मैनेजमेंट रूल नहीं पढ़ना है, तो इसमें सब कुछ नहीं पढ़ना है। फ्लाई एश यूटिलाइजेशन पर आ जाइए, तीन चार चीज़ें लिख लीजिए। प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क योजना में यूज़ होगा। फ्लाई एश कैन बी यूज एज ए न्यूट्रलाइजर इन द सॉयल। ब्रिक्स मेकिंग कैन बी वन ऑफ द मेजर पार्ट। ऑल दीज आर द यूज ऑफ फ्लाई एश विच इज वन ऑफ द कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ PM2.5। देन इंटरनेशनल कन्वेंशन, तीनों इंपॉर्टेंट है। बेसल कन्वेंशन, PT कम मेन्स, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन। इट इज अ ट्रांसबाउंड्री मूवमेंट ऑफ हैजार्डियस वेस्ट, बेसल। तो बेसल हैजार्डियस वेस्ट के लिए 1989 स्विट्जरलैंड। द ओवरीचिंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बेसल कन्वेंशन इज टू प्रोटेक्ट ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड एनवायरमेंट अगेंस्ट द एडवर्स इफेक्ट ऑफ हैजार्डियस वेस्ट। देन रोटर डैम कन्वेंशन, इट इज अ मेजर कन्वेंशन फॉर केमिकल एंड पेस्टिसाइड, इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड केम इन टू फोर्स, एंडियोसल्फान इज अ इशू रिलेटेड टू दिस। देन स्टॉकहोम कन्वेंस, इट इज अ परसिस्टेंट ऑर्गेनिक पॉल्यूटेंट। एक था मैन एनवायरमेंट समिट, वो भी स्टॉकहोम है, बट दैट इज रिलेटेड टू मैन एनवायरमेंट समिट 1972। तो दीज आर द थ्री, बेसल फॉर हैजार्डियस वेस्ट, रोटरडैम फॉर केमिकल एंड पेस्टिसाइड, स्टॉकहोम फॉर दैट इज स्टॉकहोम कन्वेंशन इज फॉर दैट इज परसिस्टेंट ऑर्गेनिक पॉल्यूटेंट। देन विनीमाटा कन्वेंशन इज फॉर मर्क्यूरी, मर्क्यूरी कंटेमिनेशन इज अ मेजर कंटेमिनेशन इन द चंबल रिवर, यमुना रिवर। दिस मर्क्यूरी कैन इम्पैक्ट अवर नर्वस सिस्टम एज वेल एज रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। विनीमाटा इज अ सिटी इन जापान, हाईली इंपॉर्टेंट। देन स्ट्रेटेजिक अप्रोच टू इंटरनेशनल केमिकल मैनेजमेंट, इट इज अ फ्रेमवर्क टू कंट्रोल केमिकल्स। देन नेशनल रिवर कंजर्वेशन प्रोग्राम में करा चुका हूँ, कंजर्वेशन वेटलैंड मैंने दे दिया, रामसर कन्वेंशन वर्ल्ड वेटलैंड दे कर सकते हो। देन नेशनल एफोरेस्टेशन एंड इको डेवलपमेंट बोर्ड, ये बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट है, पढ़ लेना। 1992 मेनली फॉर वेस्टर्न गार्ड्स एज वेल एज हिमालयास। देन नेशनल मिशन फॉर ग्रीन इंडिया, मैं ऑलरेडी बता चुका हूँ आपको, 20 मिलियन हेक्टेयर्स। देन फॉरेस्ट रिसर्च, इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल फॉरेस्ट अकेडमी देहरादून, IFS की ट्रेनिंग होती है, वाइल्ड इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया। देन बायोडाइवर्सिटी कंजर्वेशन एंड रूरल डेवलपमेंट, नेशनल ग्रीन कॉर्प्स अवेयरनेस कैंपेन, नेशनल नेचुरल कैंपेन प्रोग्राम। बाकी पूरा प्रोग्राम हमारा इंडिया बुक का दे रखा है ऑन द एस्पायर वेबसाइट, जिसको परचेज करना है वो परचेज कर सकता है। देन दिस ग्लोब प्रोग्राम इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन, ग्लोबल लर्निंग एंड ऑब्जर्वेशन टू बेनिफिट एनवायरमेंट, हैंड्स ऑन इंटरनेशनल एनवायरमेंटल साइंस एंड एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम, US गवर्नमेंट 2000 से चल रहा है, इंडिया में इसका पार्ट है। देन नेशनल ग्रीन ट्रिब्यूनल, नेचुरल जस्टिस बेंच इज इन दिल्ली, सॉरी मेजर पार्ट इज इन दिल्ली, गाइडेड बाय नेचुरल जस्टिस हैंडलिंग द ट्रिब्यूनल रिगार्डिंग एनवायरमेंटल प्रोजेक्ट्स। क्लाइमेट चेंज में पूरा करा चुका हूँ, पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं। ओजोन के लिए मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल एंड वियना कन्वेंशन, ओवर। तो दिस इज ओवरऑल एनवायरमेंट चैप्टर, आई एम होपिंग दैट यू पीपल लर्न समथिंग गुड। हैंड आउट मेरा 43 pages एंड माई लेक्चर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इंडिया बुक ओनली फ्यू पॉइंट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट, मेनली रोटरडैम, स्टॉकहोम एंड बेसल। बाकी आप इसे रिवाइज कीजिए अच्छे से, जिन्हें बैच चाहिए वो बैच ले सकते हैं। एनी क्वेरी यू कैन राइट डाउन बिलो द दिस यूट्यूब वीडियो, ऑल द कंपोनेंट आर ओवर द इंडियर बुक लेक्चर इन द PT कुंजी ऑफ द एस्पायर वेबसाइट। अच्छे से पढ़िए, हेल्दी रहिए, वी कैन कम विद हाउ टू मैनेज द टाइम इन दिस रिमेनिंग डेज एंड इन द लॉकडाउन रिमेनिंग पीरियड। तो वेट एंड वॉच, ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट, जय हिंद, जय भारत, थैंक यू।